So coming to ROC, it is again in another categorical clustering algorithm. So already we have discussed in categorical clustering algorithm called as STIR, sieving through iterative relative reinforcement. So the difference between clustering categorical attributes and clustering numerical attribute, it is two different variation and it has two different aspects. Numerical attributes, when you want to be clustered, normally distance is being used as your metric. So any distance measure can be used on numerical attributes, because in numerical attributes you can calculate the distance by using a mathematical formula. And you can find out the similarity, it can be of any type. It can be a minimum or maximum or any comparison can be enforced on numerical attributes. But when we go in for categorical attributes, the categorical attributes itself, it is a context-based representation where you cannot find out or say that similarity between two attributes or common based on any metric or any measure. So when you have an attribute, then you have to find out an alternate mechanism to group your objects with respect to clustering, and we need a specific metric to convert that categorical attribute into another representation where clustering algorithms can be applied. So normally categorical attributes, it involves converting your categorical attributes in binomial representation or binary representation for the STIR algorithm what we have discussed. So initially, generally for categorical attributes, whenever I have attribute, it has so many domain values. So domain values are the values that a single attribute can take. So if an attribute has minimum number of domain values, then grouping the attribute is easier. But when the attribute has more number of domain values, then the problem will be viewed as a complex problem. So grouping by domain values is one of the methods that is commonly used for clustering or classification for categorical attributes, where we have done the same thing in association rule mining algorithm. Whereas an association rule mining algorithm, again the database what we have considered is categorical in nature. Your item sets are represented in terms of characters, and we try to encode that character data set into a numerical data set, into a binary representation, and start finding out the correlation among the item set or correlation among the data set. Whereas for this STIR algorithm, what we do is we enforce something called as weight into each of the algorithm and try to connect the domains, that is the values which are correlated between the two attributes, and we say that the attributes are similar or this attribute can be grouped together. So initially all the attributes are assigned with weight 1, and further iteration the attribute, it has been iterated using something called as combiner function. Your combiner function is your sum of your weights or your product of your weights, so that it has been iterated until it reaches a fixed point. Once it reaches a fixed point, you stop your algorithm, and this fixed point is called as basin. So when you look on a single column of an attribute, so you can cluster your based on your weights. So the weight above the fixed point and below the fixed point, or again you can categorize with respect to this, and you can form your clustering aspect. This is what this STIR algorithm it represents. So again, this algorithm, again it has its own demerits, because always finding out the categorical attributes, converting into a numerical representation or assigning a weight, it is not possible and it does not give me a feasible solution. When I have my 10 domain values of one attribute, then I can assign a value say from 0 to 1. If I have 10,000 values for a single attribute, it means that then how do I assign my value? And if you think of your graph connectivity structure, for one attribute, if it takes 10,000 domain values or 1,000 domain values or 500 values, so in my database, if I have 60 attributes, so 60 into 500, say I have 3,000 attributes, so 3,000 attributes, when you try to represent in a graphical structure or encode in weight and I start iterating, it becomes a complex problem. The data structure, it becomes automatically complex. So another alternate approach in categorical clustering algorithm is, instead of assigning numerical weights, just providing some input as weight and start doing or iterating the process, this algorithm, it tries to group by using neighbors. Already we have seen a similar algorithm which used this neighborhood principle to group its object. So your k-means, that is your k-medoid algorithm, somebody's mobile is switch off it, manarudhila yaarudhu. Class ku varumbodhu mobile namma switch off pannanum appingiradhu class activity. அது கூட மறக்கிற அளவுக்கு பிஸியா இருக்கீங்களா என்ன? ஃபேக்கல்ட்டி எல்லாம் கிளாஸ்க்கு மொபைலே எடுத்துகிட்டு வரதே இல்லை. என்ன எமர்ஜென்சியாக இருந்தாலும் போய் பேசிக்கிறது, இல்லை அவ்வளோ எமர்ஜென்சினா வரட்டும் அப்படிங்கிறது, அன்லெஸ் ஆர் அதர்வைஸ் தெர் இஸ் அன் எமர்ஜென்சி அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு சொல்ல முடியாது. So in this neighborhood algorithm, already we have seen that Birch algorithm or your Clairaut's algorithm, it tries to find out its nearby object using its neighborhood principle. So neighborhood is an approach again used in data mining technique. So when I want to group somebody which is available in the physical space, I can group based on my neighbors. I can group all the neighbors together and say that these neighbors will have somewhat similarity between the specific application. So in this ROC algorithm, it's also this algorithm, it's going to group your categorical attributes based on its neighbors, and based on the neighborhood principle, I'm just going to draw the link. Neighbor 1 is connected with neighbor 3, neighbor 1 is connected with neighbor 5, neighbor 1 is connected with neighbor 7. So I can form a cluster grouping. So the idea of ROC algorithm is to group the clusters or to generate the clusters based on neighbors. So now my next question arises, how do I find my neighbors? So when I want to group neighbors, how do I say that attribute 1 is a neighbor to attribute 2, or attribute 1 domain value is neighbor to attribute 2 domain value? Then you have to come out with a certain condition to say that attribute 1 and 2 are neighbors, attribute 1 value and attribute 2 value are neighbors. So for that you have to find out your neighbors. And the second one, you have to find out the link. How do you establish a link between? Either I can make A1 as a neighbor to A2, or I can make A1 as a neighbor to A3. What is my criteria that I can say that this attribute is neighbor to this attribute, or I link to attribute? This is how. So this algorithm is based on work on a concept called as neighbors and link concept. So here the first iteration of your algorithm is, so this is what already we have discussed in so many ways. Clairaut's, as I said you, that Clairaut's is used in neighborhood principle. In the search, it tries to find out your neighbors and it start doing its clustering using randomized search. So randomized search is based on the neighborhood principle. The same concept is being used here. So what it is, so I say that A and B are neighbors. When I have 10 objects, when I have 10 objects, I say that 2 objects are neighbors if they have this much condition, if they have greater than some criteria. If this condition is met, then I say that these 2 people are neighbor. This is my object. So I need to maintain my threshold there. I need to maintain my threshold. So when I want to group, say when I want to group people in a specific locality, or when I want to say group is people with specific locality with respect to water treatment or with respect to something, then I can say that area 1 and area 2 can be grouped together, because area 1 I have this much of drainage outlet, area 2 I have this much of drainage outlet, and my drainage outlet, say when I have more than 20 outlets, I can say that A1 and A2 can be put into a same group, because here also there is 20 water drainage outlet, and B area also have 20 water drainage outlet. Again I can find A and C are neighbors. Again I can have A1 I have 20 outlets, C also I can have 20 outlets. So you can put A1, A2, A3, these areas in one particular group. You clear or not? So I can see it neighbor. Now my second question is, how do, whether I link A1 and A2 or I link A1 and A3. This becomes my second condition. So all are my neighbors. Which neighbor is closely related to me? Either A2 is very closely related to me or A3 is closely related to me. This becomes my second question. You clear or not what is a neighbor? So when you want a neighbor, when you have a data in a space, such as take an example that we want to set a water treatment plant for the area that is available in Badavalli. So if I take the area in Badavalli, so I may group within specific to specific conditions. So within the densely populated area of Badavalli, so when I say that 3 areas there are so much of drainage outlet, another 3 areas there are so much of drainage outlet. So when a drainage outlet is greater than some, say when I have 10 drainage outlet is my maximum criteria. When it's greater than 10, then you make all the areas which is greater than 10 in one group, all the areas which is less than 10 in one group, all the areas which is greater than 20 in one group. So I can form my different grouping. You clear or not? So this is called as my neighbor. So similarity here, it is what? Neighbors. Count of nearby objects based on certain criteria. So similarity of A1 and A2, when it's greater than a specific threshold, I call them it as my neighbor. You clear what is neighbor? So here what is my similarity? Count of my near. So what is my neighbors? My criteria. It can be any criteria. It can be a water drainage, or it can be number of count of components, or it can be again this varies depending upon my domain. In the domain, it depends upon the domain, I can set my criteria. I can say this is my neighbors. Right? So now I want to put up an say vehicle stand in Bhartiyar University. We don't have a car stand. Each department, I have my cars parked into near adjacent to the building. So when I want to have a very big vehicle stand that has to be placed, then how do I group? I have to group based on area. Which departments are neighbors? Which departments are neighbors? So now I can say the computer science block 1, block 2 or Excel department are neighbors. Or zoology is my neighbor. Commerce is also my neighbor. Because within the specific distance we, if low different distance, in the 200 meters, in the neighbors. Now 200 meters is my condition. How many of them come within my 200 meters? Botany will come into my area. So commerce will be coming into my area. Here my computer science block 2 will be coming into my area. So this is one group. Again, when I take my MBA as my neighbor, so MBA, I can say all administrative block, all control section will be in one area. And next area being so now I cannot group MBA and biotechnology. In a 200 meter mala pogo. So wherever this condition 200 meter it comes, I can form a neighboring group. So I can put some objects intervenes into the cluster. Second neighbor's quota, second my criteria, who is my nearest neighbor? Either this block 1 is my nearest neighbor or farmers is my nearest neighbor. Then only I can say that we are neighbors. Neighbors are nearer. So shortest distance. So for this case I have to establish my link. So what is the condition to establish my link is? So intersection of neighbors. So O1 you have a neighbor, O2 you have a neighbor, O3 you have a neighbor. So intersection of neighbors of O1 and O2 divided by total number of elements available. So O1 intersection O2 divided by O1 union O2, it gives me a value, so I can form a link. So wherever I have the same value of my link, I can form my link. O1 is connected to O2, O1 is neighbor of O3, O1 is neighbor of O4. Purushita, what is your similar link metric? So link metric another intersection divided by union. So O1 ko or a set of neighbor ko, O2 ko or a set of neighbor ko, O3 you have a set of neighbor. So after finding out the set of neighbors, so O1 O2 ko what are the common neighbors? That is my intersection. O1 O2 same ko motta evna neighbors. That is my union operation, set operation. So I get common neighbors illo. So 10 neighbors rendu pe rendu liyum 10 data irukudu. 10 neighbors irukanga. Idu moonu neighbors are common. So I can form O3 is my center point and I link O3 is a neighbor of O1 and O3 is a neighbor of O2. You clear with what is the concept? This is how the algorithm will get proceed. So similarity has been given by what? A intersection B divided by A union B. Right? So the same example. So here you can see that A is related to B. A is also neighbor to R and C. And R is also a neighbor to B is neighbor B. Related to R to A neighbor, so these are my neighbors. So I can form neighbors. So I can say two neighbors. I have to find out two neighbors na and neighbor matter. Three neighbors na it is three neighbors. So you can modify your algorithm anything depending upon your domain. So how do you model your algorithm? That is going to be your efficiency. So idea and methodology of the algorithm is neighborhood principle. So how should I form my neighbors? How do I link my neighbors? These are the two conditions that has to be known to work on your ROC algorithm. This is still algorithm, I am going to do this neighborhood principle, but I assign weights. This is one weight, one weight. All weights I try to iterate based on the way you start grouping, but it will not be appropriate and approximate. You clear enough? That is your limitation of that algorithm. So this is again a simple example. Data consisting of 6 attributes. It is a categorical attribute. So when I have database and in database I have 6 attributes. 6 attributes na. Attributes are represented in columns. Attributes are represented in columns. So attribute 1 la I have a domain value book. Right? Attribute B la I have 4 domain values. Water, sun, sand, swimming. Attribute 3rd column la water, sun, sand, reading. And attribute 4 la I have reading and sand. Now I form an correlation symmetric matrix. A ko B ko evlo similarity, A ko C ko evlo similarity, A and D what is the similarity. So A and A within itself I can have only one as my, this is not my symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix na da, across diagonals you will have your same values. Appa A1 A2 normal and put 0, we will not compare that self with it. But inga enna pandra A1 ku evlo attribute, ore attribute. When I compare A1 with my attribute B, do I have any common neighbors? So my value is 0. Similarly with my C, my value is 0. D, my value is 0. And guys, B to A also, that's no connectivity. So B to B, again I have been saying, B to B, I can have 1. 4 to 4, 1. So it will be 1. Within itself, 1 and 1 will be. B to C, when I say that, so B to C, I have 3 neighbors. B to 3, I have 3 neighbors. 3 divided by, this is my intersection value. What is my total number of attributes? 6. 3 divided by 6, 1 by 2, 1 by 2 is 0.6. 0.5 something around. This is how. So the entire matrix is being calculated. Now I'll find out what is the link between B and C. Aba B ko C ko ethana link irukku? 3 link. B and C, how many links I have? 3 links, 3 values. And C and D I have how many links? 3 links. C and D I have. And the matrix path to, you have to find out your values. So I have 3 values, and based on this my link, then you try to form your clusters. This is your idea of your algorithm. You clear it not? Purinchida, what is your advantage of your algorithm? So, what is the limitation of this algorithm? So, when I have 100 domain values, my complex, it becomes very complex. It becomes very complex. Upon categorical attribute, first it has to be converted into what? Some numerical representation. Upon numerical representation, what should be my idea to convert into my numerical representation? So I need some idea to convert into numerical representation. If I load a transaction database, association rule mining algorithm, we have worked with the transaction database. So all my item sets. So in that case, one customer in an item is pandranga being selected. So that's why when I want to group it, I can use this. So item 1 edukkaravangala or item 3 edukkaranga appdin paakumbodhu I can find out my records. Idellame edha base panikkanum, instances records base panni we are trying to group the objects, not on your domain values. Domain value enna pannarom, interpretation ku mattumda, representation ku da domain value. Ana grouping enadhu, monnala 10 value irukka, endile 10 value irukka, idu rendu oru group. So angella instances, record level instances. Record level, it's not column level instances. Column level instances, what you do? You do representation alone column based, but you group based on what? A row level instances. A and B are similar. So A, B, C similar, A allow group, B allow group, C allow group. This is how you follow this. This is the limitation of this particular algorithm. Okay? So that is what it is being given. It is free from the chain effect phenomena. Wait, iteration. 1, 2, 3, you have a chain of values, but here you don't have anything. So here there is chances of outliers. Neighbors varlana, nobody is neighbor to me. Then what will I do? Nobody is, I don't fit into any of my group. For the given condition. But condition na anga matter. Condition kula varlana, I cannot be an outlier. When my condition varies, there is chances for me to get into some of the group. So this algorithm, it is what to say, sensitive to outliers. It is sensitive to knots. This is the meaning of this algorithm. Complexity, that is what given. So the similarity will loosen considerably when the complexity will explode. When you have more number of domain values, the algorithm tend to be very, very complex, because implementing it is very, very difficult. In order real-time data, categorical data, you cannot fix up with your domain values. So you say you can take your any online e-commerce website. It can be eBay or it can be Flipkart. So it has more 10,000 products. Both of the customer, they choose different combination of my products. So when you want to group this cluster pattern, now I have to find out in the customer, in the product, neighboring products. In the product, that is my neighbors here. Flipkart and eBay, what is my neighbors? Product A, whoever has purchased product A, was got what are the remaining products? B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Aba A vaangnaangala, B, C, D, E, F vaangna, A oda neighbors. B vaangnaangala, C, D, E, F vaangna, C oda neighbors. Aba A and B ki yara neighbor? Rendu perku common a irukkuravanga da neighbor. This is my link.
You're clear or not? This is how we have to remodel your algorithm. So which domain you want to model your algorithm, there your condition and criteria, it gets modified and it gets changed. I think you can take down this, whatever you have understood it, you can take down. I'll leave the PPT and see. So here it is, your you have another important thing, and it's a goodness measure. Being selected, we have my measure. So this is called as your goodness measure. So goodness measure one day, summation of I equal to 1 to k, n is your total number of objects and link of two objects divided by 1 plus 2 f theta. அதில் வந்து p q p r இட் பிலாங்ஸ் டு தி டோட்டல் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஆப்ஜெக்ட். சிங்கிறது டோட்டல் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஆப்ஜெக்ட். ஸோ எஃப் தீட்டா அப்படிங்கிறது வந்து இவ்வளோ டைபாஸ் இருக்கிறதுங்கிறது, தீட்டா வேல்யூங்கிறது வாட் பி கிவ். ஸோ இது எதுக்குன்னா கிளஸ்டர்ஸ் வந்து கரெக்டாக குரூப்பாக இருக்குதா, மெஷரிங் தி குட்னஸ் ஆஃப் தி கிளஸ்டர், வெதர் தி கிளஸ்டர் இஸ் ரைட் கிளஸ்டர் ஆர் தி கிளஸ்டர் வேல்யூ இட் இஸ் ஃபார்ம்ட் இஸ் குட், வி வெரிஃபை மேத்தமெட்டிக்கலி யூசிங் திஸ் ஃபார்முலா. So here my theta value is 1 minus theta by 1 plus theta. So theta it can be any value, 1 by 2 or 2 by 2, enna manani kudla. This measure is called as what? Goodness measure. Goodness measure, it is used to validate the clustering output. Whether my cluster has grouped the objects, whether it is right or not. That is called as validation and verification. So yella time cluster grouping vandu correct a irukadu. Sometimes my grouping might be wrong. Adhaadu indha criteria kulla varada element kuda group kulla vandirukalam. Appa my algorithm I have to say that this algorithm is 70% correct na, the validation metric la you have to evaluate and you have to come up with the result. What Lawrence, are you clear? Are you in the class? You are in the class? It seems you are not in the class. You are physically here and somewhere there. You can leave this. So this is what we leave all those things. This is again my goodness measure, number of crosslinks between pair of links, all those things. So this is your pseudocode. This is how the algorithm, it has been written in form of a pseudocode, very simple representation in form of pseudocode, but it is very difficult to extract your links or neighbors and so on. So you need not bother about all those things, but you should know. So your computing complexity, it is what? N square. N square and n log n, exponential, it is exponential, high complexity. Data domains increase aha, computational time also it gets increases, doubled. So that is why you have always with your my n square, exponential. Log n abdinale exponential, log measure vandale n attribute adhe, log vandale n attribute adhe. Ratio scale variables are in a variables. Ordinal variable, nominal variable, interval scale variable, then ratio scale variables. So ratio அப்படினால இந்த logarithmic ல தான் வேல்யூ இருக்கும். logarithmic ல வேல்யூ எடுக்கிறனாலே the value it cannot be counted normally. It goes into 10 to the power of minus 29 or 39. So time it will be increasing to a higher extent. அதுக்கு தான் log value எடுக்கும். exponent value க்கு தான் you convert into your logarithmic value. So log n அப்படினாலே time complexity is somewhat higher. வெறும் n, O of n அப்படின்னா O of n square னா quadratic, double the time. Of log n அப்படினா log n exponentially it will be increasing. N square is very complex. N log n again a linear and some time. This is what you have to understand with respect to time complexity and space complexity. So I think we need not go into those things. Right? So these are your I think high worst case complexity depends on the value of k. This is what we have already said. You clear with this algorithm? This you take down and we go for another algorithm. It is called as cactus. I'll just give you 2 minutes time.